You see, you can't live the Christian life without the power of the Holy Spirit. I don't care how much you believe. You can believe, you can read the Bible, but I'll tell you, you'll never, never be able to live the Christian life unless you're filled with God's Holy Spirit. Even Almighty God did not expect anyone to live the Christian life without the power of the Holy Spirit. And the person who treats that as some sort of extra, you know, like the ice cream at the end of the meal. Oh, well, it doesn't matter if I don't have the ice cream either, because I had my lunch. No, it's not that. It's everything. If you don't have the Holy Spirit, you got nothing. You got knowledge. You're no better than anybody in the Old Testament. They didn't have the Holy Spirit there in the Old Testament dwelling in them. And I believe a lot of problems that Christians face today, their fundamental sources, they have not sought to be filled with God's Holy Spirit. They're trying to live the Christian life, and they live a good life like a lot of heathen people live a good life. And you think this person who believes in Jesus lives a good life because he believes in Jesus, you say he's born again. That heathen fellow lives just as good a life. He doesn't believe in Jesus, you say he's not born again. It's all crazy. The difference is that a Christian is filled with the Holy Spirit. Now I want to ask you, all of you, this question. Are you sure that you're filled with the Holy Spirit? If you're not, what in the world are you doing? Why aren't you disturbed about it? Why aren't you disturbed about it? Why aren't you concerned that the power of the Holy Spirit is not there? I mean, if you build a house and you ask the Karnataka Electricity Board for an electric power connection, you won't get it, by the way, if you don't ask for it. It's the same with God. You've got to ask for it. The only thing is, with God there's no corruption. You don't have to give a bribe to receive the Holy Spirit. And you don't need an electrical contractor or anything. But you apply to the Karnataka Electricity Board for an electricity connection and they don't give it to you. What do? You tell your wife, well, we sit in darkness. No, I've never heard anybody who does that. They keep going to the office and say, we got to get our connection. We applied for it. We applied for it 2 months ago. Why haven't we got the connection? Why can't we go to God like that? Why can't we go to God and say, God, I've received Christ into my life. Why can't I be filled with the Holy Spirit? Give me a power connection. My fridge is not working. My tape recorder is not working. The lights are not burning. The fans are not running in my life. Give me a power connection, Lord. I really believe you need to pray. I believe there are many of you here who need to earnestly seek God, because God sees you're content to live in the darkness. That's why He doesn't fill you. And it's this Holy Spirit that's supposed to communicate to us that mighty resurrection power of Jesus Christ. The power of the Holy Spirit is the same as the power of His resurrection. The Bible speaks about the power that raised Jesus from the dead. That means lifted Him up over the worst thing the devil could do to Him. Death. God says, that's nothing. I can overcome that. That's the power that God wants to give us. The power that lifts us up over fear and sin and discouragement and gloom and bad moods and every wretched thing the devil has put upon us.